Hello again, folks. This is Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. And tonight's going to be kind of just a short and sweet video on a rather unusual unit. This is a Blahpunk radio, Blahpunk Frankfurt style radio. And this radio has a few unusual features. One of them, it has a push-on, push-off switch. It's not a rotary control where you turn it. The volume control, of course, is rotary, but turning it on and off, you just push the switch. Another feature it has is the kind of a hidden tone control. To adjust the tone, you pull it out, then you rotate it. And then wherever you stop rotating it and let it go back inside, that's where the tone control is going to stay. That's kind of a neat little feature. It saves a little bit of space and an extra knob, I suppose. And then a third little unusual quirk is that on a lot of these Blahpunk German radios, some of the buttons force a certain band to be used. Now, this radio originally had medium wave and AM and FM. Obviously, the medium wave is no longer in use, but it does tie up a push button that cannot be used for AM or FM. So, and then in addition to that, you have two push buttons labeled AM. They can only be used for AM stations. They will not tune to FM because the way the radio originally was, and you can kind of see the indicator over here, if you press the AM push button, it forces the AM band. So at any rate, when I finish doing my conversion on this, you can use all five push buttons for FM stations if you like, or you can use any one of them for AM as well. And so we're just going to go ahead and turn this thing on real quick. It's just a quick test. Oh, and finally, this radio was originally in a 12-volt positive ground vehicle. And the vehicle was not converted to negative ground, so that means we had to install also an HPC power adapter inside the radio, which does add to the cost of the conversion. But at any rate, I've got the radio set up for 12-volt positive ground. I have a 12-volt positive ground supply feeding it, and we've got our antenna plugged in and all that stuff. So we're just going to go ahead and turn it on, run it through a few of its paces just to make sure everything works, and then we're going to quit and so I can get back to some other jobs that are awaiting my attention. Let's go ahead and turn it on. There we go. Alrighty, and I'm not going to go to all the trouble. It is after sundown. It's about 9 o'clock at night, so we probably won't pick up anything on the AM band. And I'm sure you know by now from watching my other videos that all you got to do is turn the unit off, turn it right back on to switch between AM and FM. So we won't go through all that rigmarole. Let's go ahead and zoom out just a touch. Okay, and I'm just going to run the through all the push buttons. Pick up some FM stuff here. Looks like the stations have drifted a bit since I set it. Okay, so that's just a quick demonstration to show that the push buttons can still be preset. I have them all preset to FM stations. Not going to bother switching to AM just yet, or in this video. Okay, now we're going to adjust the tone. We have to pull this volume control out to adjust the tone. And you can see we've lost some of our treble there, which was our intention. Turn our tone control back up. Okay, and now we're going to, this radio did not originally have left-right balance control or a front-rear fader, and now it does in the form of the tone control. And you've seen a bunch of my videos in which I rotate the tone control. Well, on this particular radio, of course, we have to pull the shaft out to adjust the tone, which means we also have to have the shaft pulled out to adjust the virtual balance and fader. So let's go ahead and try that, make sure that function works. I'm going to set my tone control to roughly the center position so I've got room to rotate it. And we're going to rotate it twice to the right to activate the front rear fader. Let's go ahead and bring our output level meters in the picture so we can watch what we're doing here, see the results of the adjustments. Alrighty, give us a little bit more volume. Okay, now we're going to activate our virtual fader. Pull the tone control out, two turns to the right. There's our four beeps letting us know that after that, we can now adjust the front rear fader action with the tone control. Front. Rear. Okay, so that function is timed out, and now the tone control is just a tone control again. You can hear it removing the treble. And since I don't have a knob on this control, it's kind of hard to keep it pulled out and turn it. Now we're going to activate the left-right balance control. Same procedure, except we rotate that tone control twice to the left. So here we go. There's our beeps. Okay, and now the tone control is adjusting left, right, left. Ah, hard to hold on to without the knob. Alrighty, with a timeout. Okay, so we've demonstrated the virtual balance fader, the virtual fader function, the virtual balance function. Not going to bother with the AM right now, but I am going to go ahead and activate the Bluetooth function. We're going to give our volume control two quick turns to the right, and we should hear a female voice saying, ready to pair. So here we go. Oops. I mistakenly had the control pulled out while doing that. Let's try it again.
Ready to pair.
Okay, and there's a female voice saying ready to pair, and now it's trying to pair with a Bluetooth device. If I had a Bluetooth device here ready to pair with it, it would pair with it and start working. So we're just going to let that time out. After 90 seconds, the lady will come back on saying pairing not completed, and in fact, let's just go ahead and just eliminate that delay. Okay, now we're on the AM band. Okay, now we're going to make sure that the USB function works, and I'm just going to plug my, let's go ahead and go back to the main view of the radio here, and I'm just going to plug my radio commercial on the USB stick into the USB jack and make sure it works, and here we go. Okay. My commercial playing off the USB stick. You can see the USB stick's flashing, indicating data transfer. Unplug it, radio comes right back. Okay, and that's it. That tests all the functions of the converted radio with the USB and Bluetooth features. It also has a line input, but since this radio is currently running off of a positive ground power supply, I'm a little bit afraid to feed any signals from my test equipment because my test equipment is properly grounded and I don't want to blow anything up here. So I did test the line input beforehand, and that is working correctly. It will automatically switch to the line input when there's a signal present at those line input jacks, and I'll just give you a quick look at that stuff here. Just unplug this antenna, and this is our radio. This is the Bluetooth / USB module, and in this installation we're only using the mic jack, so I only had the mic jack labeled. The other jack is for an optional push button, and that's only used if you're not installing it into a converted radio. And then on the back here we just have our RCA jacks for our line input, and that's pretty much it. These are just the mounting bolts for the FM conversion module. So that's our cool little Blahpunk Frankfurt radio. This is for XKS Unlimited in California, a very highly respected car restoration shop. And I'm honored to be one of their behind the scenes guys for repairing and converting their radio. So that concludes the test here. Everything is working correctly. This is Barry with Barry's 8-Track and Classic Car Radio Repair. If you have an 8-Track player, either for home or for car, in need of service, you can reach me directly at 928-533-9666. And obviously, if you have a classic car AM radio that you would like to add FM to, or even an AM-FM radio that you would like to convert to modern electronics with a lot more output power, and the additional possibilities of installing the Bluetooth and USB features and a line input, you can contact me for those reasons also, of course. My website is in the description below. Thank you very much for watching and listening, and we'll see you next time.